Hello students, today in this video I will explain you chapter number 2. The name of the chapter is fraction. So the topic name is fraction. What is fraction? All those numbers which are written in the form of A upon B. Here A is known as numerator and B is known as denominator. Example. As an example I can give you here 2 upon 3. Here I had written this number in the upon format. Upon is there, this is the numerator and this is the denominator. So such numbers are known as fraction. Now types of fraction. First type of fraction is common fraction. Common fraction. So as the name denotes here, common. Common means all those fractions in which numerator and denominators are the integers value. As an example, 2 upon 3, 4 upon 5, 1 upon 2. Here, numerator as well as denominators both are integers. Integers means here negative value we can take also. Negative value also we can take. So, if the numerator and denominator both are integers, then such fractions are known as common fraction. And second type of fraction is complex fraction. Complex means looking little bit difficult or different from this common one. So complex fraction, as an example I can give you 2 upon 3 upon 4 upon 3. So here what you are looking here in the numerator as well as in the denominator, both are fraction. These two are fraction. Or another example I can give you. In the numerator it is fraction. In the denominator it is integer. So such type of fractions are known as complex fraction. So in the complex fraction, what is the difference between common fraction and complex fraction? In the common fraction, both numerator and denominators are integers. But in the complex fraction, either numerator will not be the integer, here it is fraction. In the numerator it is coming fraction. Here in this example, both numerator and denominator are in the fraction. Another example, in the numerator it is integer, but in the denominator it is fraction. So such types of fractions are known as complex fraction. So complex fractions are those in which numerator or denominator or both numerator and denominator are the fraction. These are not the integers. So such types of fractions are known as complex fraction. Now third type of fraction is proper fraction. Proper fraction. Third type. Proper fraction. Proper fraction. What is proper fraction? If the numerator of the fraction is less than the denominator, here I had written 2 upon 3, numerator is less than denominator. Another example is 5 upon 10, here numerator is less than denominator. So such fractions are an example of the proper fraction. Fourth one is improper fraction. Improper fraction. So in the improper fraction, numerator will be greater than the denominator. So such fractions are known as improper fraction. Here I had taken in the numerator 3, in the denominator here I had written 2. Numerator is greater than denominator, so such examples are known as improper fraction. It is given in your textbook also on page number N17. So these are definitions you have to read once. Now next type is mixed fraction. Mixed fraction. Fifth type of fraction is mixed fraction. So what are mixed fraction? An integer together with a proper fraction. Integer means positive number also we can take, negative number also we can take. Let's take an example, minus 2. This is the integer. This integer together with the proper fraction. Proper fraction means numerator is less than the denominator. This is the example. the integer with the proper fraction. Another example, if we will take positive integer we can take 3 together with the proper fraction. Proper fraction means numerator is less than the denominator, that means 2 upon 3. So such examples are of mixed fractions. So what are mixed fractions? Mixed fractions are those in which integers is combined with the proper fraction. Here this is the example of mixed fraction. Now we will start solving the question of the exercise. So the first question of your exercise number 2A is, express the following as mixed fraction. Exercise number 2A. Exercise 2A. First question is, we have to convert in mixed fraction. First part, 37 upon 12 is given. And we have to change in mixed fraction. In order to convert in mixed fraction, first of all, you have to divide 37 with 12. 12 3 is 36. On subtracting it, we will get remainder as 1. So what we have to do? On dividing 37 by 12, when we are divided 37 by 12, 3 is the answer. So this 3 you have to write in the whole. So 3 whole. Remainder we have to write upside, 1 upon denominator we have to write same what is given in the question. So this is the answer. We had converted this fraction into mixed fraction. So in order to convert in mixed fraction, what you have to do? First of all, you have to divide it. Then remainder we have to write upside. The answer which is coming here, that answer we have to write in the whole. And the number by which we have divided, that number we have to write in the denominator. So here we are getting 3 whole 1 upon 12. See another part, part number 3rd. 316 upon 23. So first of all, what we will do? We will show the division. With a table of 23, we have to divide 316. First of all, we will divide these two digits. Number, two digit number is 31. 23 1 ja 23. On subtracting it, we will get 8. 6 will come downside. This is 86. 23 3 ja 69. On subtracting it, we will get 17. So your remainder is 17 here. So what we have to do? The answer which is coming here, that answer we have to write in the whole. So 13 whole, remainder we have to write on the top. So 17 we will write here. Upon this 23 we have to write in the denominator only. So final answer is 13 whole 17 upon 23. So like this you have to do question number first. Now come to question number second. Express the following as improper fraction. In question second, we have to convert in improper fraction. First part, 3 whole 7 upon 12. In order to convert in improper fraction, what you have to do? 12 we have to multiply by 3. After multiplying this 12 by 3, this numerator number we have to add plus 7. In the denominator, we have to write same number which is given in the question, that is 12. So 12 into 3 plus 7 divided by 12. On solving it, we will get, according to the board mass, we have to multiply first. 12 3 is 36 plus 7 upon 12. On adding it, 43 upon 12. This is the answer. Here we had converted it into improper fraction. Why this is improper fraction? Because numerator is greater than denominator. That's why it is the improper fraction. So like this, you have to do question number second. Now come to question number third. Third question, fill in the blanks. First part, 4 upon 9 is equal to dash upon 36. So here we are observing that in the denominator on the left hand of equal to 9 is there. On the right hand of equal to denominator is 36. So 9 4 ja 36 is there. 9 multiply 4 when we will do, then only we will get 36. So here we are multiplying with 4. So in the numerator also we have to multiply with 4. So 4 multiply 4 will be 16. This is your answer of part number first. See another part. Part number second. 5 upon 11 is equal to 40 upon 10. Here in the numerator 5 is there. Here in the numerator 40 is there. 40 is greater. So number is increasing. Increasing means we have to multiply. 5, 8 ja 40. So here we are multiplying with 8. So in the denominator also we will multiply with 8. 11, 8 ja 88. So this is your answer of part number 2. Now part number 4th. Part number 4th, 219 upon dash is equal to 2 whole 3 upon 35. First of all, what we will do? We will convert this mixed fraction. So 219, we will write as it is. I am solving here. 219 upon dash. Equal, we will change this mixed fraction. 35 to the 70 plus 3 will be 73 upon 35. So here we are observing in the numerator on the right side 73 is there, on the left side 290 is there. So 73 multiply we have to do. Why we have to multiply? Because this number is greater. So 73 3 ja 290. So in the denominator also we will multiply with 3. So when we will multiply 35 by 3, then we will get 105. So this is the final answer of part number 4th. Now come to question number 4th. Fourth question. In the fourth question, heading of the question is, write each of the following in the simplest form. You have to change in the simplest form. 144 upon 336. What you have to do? You have to cut them with the same table. Numerator as well as denominator, we have to cancel with the same table. First of all, we will cancel them with the table of 2. It is easy to cancel these two with the table of 2. 2 7 ja 14, 2 2 ja 4, 2 1 ja 2, remainder 1, 1 and 3 13, 2 6 ja 12, 1 remainder, 1 and 6 16, 2 8 ja 16. Now with a table of 4 we can cancel these two together. 4, 4 1 ja 4, 4 8 ja 32, 4 4 ja 16, 4 2 ja 8. Now here it is 18 and here it is 42. With a table of 6 we can cancel. Both are coming in a table of 6. 6 3 is 18. 6 7 is 42. So on cancelling them we are getting 3 upon 7. So this is the simplest form of this question. So in the simplest form what you have to do? In the simplest form you have to cancel both numerator and denominator with the same table. First we had cancelled with a table of 2. After that we had cancelled with a table of 4. Then after that we are observing that these two are coming in a table of 6. So we have cancelled them with this table of 6. Both number we have to cancel with the same table only. So like this you have to do question number 4. So now rest of the questions I will explain you in the next video. So your homework is you all have to finish up to question number 4th of exercise number 2A. Question number 5 and 6 I will explain you in the next video. So this is your homework which you have to do in your paper.